Blackstone Audio presents North on the Wing, Travels with the Songbird Migration of Spring by Bruce M. Beehler. This book is read by Keith Sellon-Wright, a member of SAG-AFTRA. In memory of Carrie Baxter Beehler, Edwin Way Teal, and Nellie Donovan Teal. Introduction. An interest in nature leads you into a kind of enchanted labyrinth. You wander from corridor to corridor. One interest leads to another interest, one discovery to another discovery. It matters little where you begin. Edwin Way Teal, Circle of the Seasons. In February 1947, the naturalist Edwin Way Teal and his wife, Nellie, took an adventurous automobile trip in search of nature. Driving on country roads through farmland and prairie, forest and marsh, mountains and swamp, the Teals tracked the progress of spring from the Florida Everglades to northern New England. Moving north as the days lengthened and warmed, songbirds of many species greeted the Teals through the American landscape. The Teals took in local history and culture and explored little-known green spaces as they followed the birds' own journeys. The account of their travels, North with the Spring, the first of Edwin Way Teal's grand quartet of seasonal natural history travelogues, was published in 1951. I first encountered Teal's tale of spring migrations in the late 50s, when my mother read passages from it to me and my brother on our cozy living room sofa before bedtime. Our mother, a single parent who worked as a dental assistant to pay the bills, was rediscovering her own childhood love of nature through her avocational reading of Teal, Henry David Thoreau, Isaac Dennison, Hal Borland, Elspeth Huxley, and others, prowling the local library in search of nature in the written word, and bringing her discoveries home to share with us. Thus, long before I'd even decided to become an ornithologist, in the days when I was first exploring the nearby woods and fields, Teal's migrant birds became nighttime visitors to our home through our mother's reading. At that time, the northern neighborhoods of Baltimore, where I grew up, were still dotted with forest tracks. Wood thrushes sang from the shade of the woodsy stream bottoms, and coveys of bobwhite quail visited our backyard garden. My brother Bill and I were free to range widely for hours. When not in school, we children wandered, discovering the outdoors on our hikes to Tramp Rock in nearby Gilman Woods. Midway through spring, in their murmuring flocks, myrtle warblers flashed their golden rumps in red maples that were just starting to push out their pale, pinkish-green leaves. Bill and I would take note of these northbound migrants as well as the monotonous but cheerful territorial singing of northern flickers. At the end of the day, we were called home by the sound of the brass school bell that our mother rang to signal us in for dinner. In 2015, after a lifetime spent observing birds around the world, I decided to take a road trip up the Mississippi Valley to the Great North Woods to experience spring migration as the Teals had done, but along a different pathway. I would first meet the migrant birds on the coast of Texas after they had made their journey across the Gulf of Mexico, returning stateside from their tropical wintering grounds. Then, tracking spring's march up through the continent, I would follow the migrants as they moved northward in fits and starts. I would meet these birds at an array of favored stopover sites and mid-country nesting spots from Texas to Canada, and I'd seek out the most peripatetic of the migrants on their nesting territories in the boreal forests of northern Ontario and high in the Adirondack Mountains of northern New York State. I would travel the back roads and camp in the woods. Each night, from the comfort of my tent, I would listen to the last of the evening's bird song, and each morning I'd wake to their cheerful dawn voices. My trip had several purposes beyond hearkening back to the Teal's own journey. As a practicing field naturalist, I wanted to experience, firsthand, spring migration at its most effulgent, right through the country's midsection. I wanted to witness spring's procession up the Great Riverway and spend time in the prettiest patches of green scattered up and down the Mississippi. As a research biologist, I also hoped to learn about the people who are studying migratory birds in the field. And, having experienced firsthand the long-term declines of migratory birds, I wanted to see the work that various institutions are doing to restore migration to its former abundance. I planned to focus my 100-day birding excursion on the wood warblers. These brightly patterned songbirds constitute the heart of the continent's avian migratory system, and their well-being is a bellwether for the health of other bird species.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.